Minasan konnichiwa. Watashi wa Jed desu. Nihongo no sensei. So, good day everyone again. So, my name is Jed sensei or Teacher Jade or Sir Jade. Just call me Sir Jade. And actually, this is a continuation of my lecture about ano naman ito, about daika. Okay, daika or how to use be verb des, especially in occupation in Japanese. So this is another Nihongo lecture series na naman. Okay, so before we start, do not forget to subscribe my channel, Jade Fortis Pulong Barit. So please like, share, and subscribe. And alam ko may matututunan kayo sa araw na to. So, are you ready? Are you ready? Kurasu, watashi no kurasu. Ikuzo. Okay, so this is daika or be verb des. So, learning objectives. So, discuss how to use Japanese pronouns and the conjugation of be verb des in the sentence. And then, we're going to, you need to memorize some of the useful expression in Japanese and give example of sentence by using be verb des. But here, only focus lang tayo in be verb des. Alright. So, here, number one tip, please memorize Japanese pronoun. So, if you remember the hi, you, he, she. So, these are, ayan, ito po. Hi, I. I, you, he, she. So, kapag I, first person singular pronoun. You, second person singular pronoun. He and she, the third person singular pronoun. So, ang mangyayari po, pag translate natin yan, it's watashi, watakushi, atashi, anata. Kapag you, anata, or kimi. Again, dumun na tayo sa I. Watashi. Watakushi. Atashi. Okay, kapag lalaki, pwede pong gamitin yung boku. And then, ore, kapag mas masculine po, parang para piling mo macho, ore. And, or boku. Okay? And then, you, anata. Kimi. So, this is more informal. Informal po ito. Okay? Anata, it's formal. Okay, so that is a how to use you in Japanese sentence, okay? So, Kimi is, for example, by an adult talking to children or to someone intimate. This is the same word as name suffix kun used towards junior. Okay? And then, omae, another one, omae. You are really getting into someone's face with this one, but can be used with someone very intimate. That is omae. Okay? So, that is you. And then he, kare. Kare. Kare is also, the meaning of kare, that is a boyfriend. No, also boyfriend. But boyfriend, it's Bowie Purendo, but most of them, they use kare pag sinasabi yung boyfriend. And same thing with she, kanojo, or kapag kanojo, ginagamit din sa word na girlfriend, okay? But in another term ng girlfriend, garu purendo. So that is also a pronoun, he, kare, she, kanojo. Kapag ano naman po, kapag we, that is first person plural na. Okay, ito. Pag we, first person plural, watashi tachi, watakushi, tachi, atashi tachi, ware-ware. Okay, most commonly used is watashi tachi. This is most formal. And then you, anata tachi, anata, you, second person plural. Example, all of you are my students. So, ibig sabihin, you're talking to lots of students. So, you, anata tachi. They, na boys, third person plural, karera. And then, they na girls, third person plural, kanojo tachi. But, if you're going to use, pag mix po, example, they sila, mix sila, both men and women. Okay, karera ang gagamitin. Karera. Okay? And then, let's go back. Kapag possessive pronoun naman, yung my, your, his, or her. So, in Japanese pronoun, just add suffix no to become possessive pronoun. Example, pag may, watashi no. Your, anata no. His, kare no. Her, kanojo no. And then, pag plural naman, our, watashi tachi no. Your, anata tachi no. Their, karera no. Their, kanojo tachi no. So, just add sa add suffix no, okay, in the pronoun, in the Japanese pronoun, to become possessive Japanese possessive pronoun. Okay, so if you have some questions, don't hesitate to ask me. Shitsumu no arimasu ka, watashi no kurasu. All right, daijoubu desu ka? Honto ni? Ah, yoku yatta. Sample: what is your name? Ayan. So, as you can see, ang always technique po, lagi pong uunahin ang noun. And then, the particle wa. And then, the noun or the subject. And then, des. Des na, yung be verb des. So, okay, I'm going to show you muna. Actually, this is all about present tense naman ito. Present tense. Okay, so what is your name? Anata no onomai wa nan desu ka? Anata no onomai wa nan desu ka? So yung your, anata no onomai. So if you remember, yung namai, nilagyan ko ng particle to become polite. So anata no onomai wa nan desu ka? Anata no onomai wa nan desu ka? Anata no onomai. So anata no, that is possessive pronoun. So, hindi mo na lagyan ng particle wa because yung no, that is already a particle. Yung suffix no. So, no need. Kasi ginagamit lang yun after the Japanese pronoun. But it is possessive pronoun. So, suffix no, it's enough. So, anata no. But, next one, onamai. Okay. So, onamai, you're asking the name. So, namai, onamai, particle wa, nang, desu ka? Anata no, onamai wa nang desu ka? Example, I am Takeru. Yan, yung taga Takeru Sato, no? I am Takeru. Watashi wa Takeru desu. No? Watashi wa Takeru desu. So, that's very easy. So, I, watashi, followed by particle, suffix wa, Takeru desu. You are Itomaki. You are Itomaki. Anata wa Itomaki sang desu. Example, if you're introducing other person or you're calling someone, just add sang to show politeness or to show respect. So, anata wa Itomaki sang desu. Eh, kung bata, sabi ko nga, kun. Kung mas yang sa'yo, kun. Or, kapag mas bata, chan. Okay? Okay, so, anata wa Itomaki sang desu. O pwede ko siyang tawagin, anata wa Itomaki-chan desu. Kasi, ito si Itomaki, feeling young. Feeling bata. Ito-chan daw, ito-chan. I is Yusuke. I is Yusuke. Karo wa Yusuke sang desu. So, as you can see, nilagyan ng sang. Karo wa Yusuke sang desu. So, yung kare, i, followed by particle wa, Yusuke sang desu. She is Miho. Same thing. Kanojo wa Miho sang desu. Kanojo wa Miho sang desu. My name is Jade. So this is possessive pronoun already. So, watashi no namai wa Jade desu. So hindi ko na nilagyan ng O kasi pinintroduce ko naman yung sarili ko. Watashi no namai wa Jade desu. O pwede din naman. Watashi no namai wa Jade desu. Or Jedo desu. Jedo is my Japanese name. Your name is Mr. Miyagi. Anata no onamai wa, kumbaga, sinasabi mo na, ikaw, ang pangalan niya ay Mr. Miyagi. Anata no onamai wa Miyagi sang desu. Next, his name is Shinsuke. Shinsuke. Kare no onamai wa Shinsuke sang desu. And her name is Sheki. You're introducing Sheki. Kanojo no onamai wa Sheki sang desu. Okay, so that is more on introducing names. In application of pronoun and Japanese pronoun and possessive pronoun in Japanese. Okay, now another technique. Please memorize the conjugation of this. Kumbaga, yung pagpapalit, yung pag-conjugate or pagpalit-palit ng this into present, past form, negative, affirmative, negative, and interrogative. Kapag affirmative, ang this, kapag ang sentence niya nagsisimula sa I am, he is, she is, you are, this ang huli. Wala pong gagawin sa linking verb. Walang translation yun. Ang mangyayaring translation yan na sa dulo, which is yung des. Okay? Another one, deshta kapag past tense na. Example po, I was, you were, she was, he was. Okay, next one, kapag negative naman yung sentence na present. Example, I am not, you are not, he is not, she is not. Okay, kapag past tense naman, ang mangyayari po, mga ganitong sentence sa English, I was not, you were not, she was not, he was not. And then, kapag interrogative, it's all about questioning. Example, am I? Are you? Kapag des ka, am I? Are you? Is he? Is she? Des ka magiging dulo nun. Deshta ka naman kapag past tense. Example, was I, were you, was he, was she. Okay. So, this is another important technique because this is the last part of this sentence. And then, another thing, because since this is the application of the occupation. Occupation, di ba? Okay, so ito eh, ipapakita ko po sa inyo yung shokugyo na sinasabi, shokugyo or yung mga tsutome na tinatawag, o shigoto. Okay, example, Reibun, he is a student. Ayan, he is a student. Look at this, he, karewa, student, gakuse, des. So, napansin ninyo, yung sentence niya is affirmative in present form kasi yung he is, so automatic, lagay mo na agad karewa. Kasi yung he is possessive naman. Karewa, and then what is after karewa, yung occupation or yung occupation or title. Example, gakuse. And then, des. So that is, yan na yung des. Ito na sinasabi ko, dyan na mag-start mag-conjugate. Titignan nyo lang po ito, yung linking verb. Ito po yung pronoun tsaka yung linking verb. Always remember that because diyan na po magkakaroon ng changes or conjugation yung des. Example, o katulad nito, he was a doctor, so naging past tense na yung linking verb, past na. Okay, so he was a doctor, karewa, so same thing, karewa, isha deshta. Karewa, isha deshta. He was a doctor. O, ito na yung negative na yung sentence na present. So, she is not a scholar. She is not a scholar. She is not, ayan po. So, ibig sabihin, may pagbabago na yan sa conjugation. So, ano chua? Ganun pa rin. Same thing, walang babaguin. Style, ganun pa rin ang style. Always remember this pattern. Ganito po ang pattern yan. Yung pronoun muna, particle, tapos yung occupation. Kaya kailangan memorize yung pronoun. Mag-memorize ka ng maraming mga shokugyo. Importante, mga shokugyo. Example, receptionist, Uketsuke Gakari, Doctor, Isha, Dentist, Aisha, Student, Gakuse, Teacher, Sensei. Malaking bagay. If you want to construct this type of bunsho or sentence. So, here, and then, pronoun. Diba? Kasi pronoun ang nangunguna dito. Kumbaga, kumbaga tinutukoy mo siya, siya yung subject. Ano siya? Anong klaseng, ano siya? Anong occupation niya? Anong title niya? Kumbaga, example, she is not a scholar. Ibig sabihin, tinutukoy mo na hindi siya scholar. Itong babaeng ito. So, kanojo ma, gaku siya, dewa arimasen. Kanojo wa hakusha dewa arimasen. I was not a teacher. Ayun, tinutukoy mo yung sarili mo na yung hindi ka naging teacher. Past tense. I was not. Oh. So, watashi wa. Watashi wa sensei dewa arimasen. Deshita. Watashi wa. Watashi wa sensei. Same pattern, no? Basta always first pronoun, followed by particle wa. Occupation or any title. And then, the conjugation of this. That is only a pattern. Basta kahit affirmative man yan, negative or interrogative. Next one, are you a designer? Anata wa designer desu ka? So that is double ano yan. Anata wa designer desu ka? So, ito, interrogative ito, pa-question po ito. So, mangyayari, magbabaliktad po dito, magkakaroon reverse dito sa English. But here, walang reversing, ganun pa rin po ang magkoconjugate, magdadagdagan po ng ka kasi for interrogative question. So, anata wa designer desu ka? Was he a tour guide? So that is past tense na interrogative. So, karewa kanku gaido? Karewa kanku gaido? Dashita ka? Okay, so right pronunciation po tayo. Karewa gakusei des. Karewa? Karewa gakusei des. Karewa isha des ta? Karewa isha des ta? Kanojo wa gakusha dewa arimasen. Watashi wa sensei dewa arimasen deshita. Anata wa designer desu ka? Karewa kanku gaido deshita ka? Okay, that is right pronunciation. Alright. So, here, I'm going to show you something, another reboot or review. Chotto mate. Chotto mate, kudasai. Alright, alright. Chotto mate. Mate, I'm going to show you something more and more para marami po tayong matutunan sa ating lecture for today. Okay, as you can see in my whiteboard, I hope nakikita niyo po yung whiteboard ko. Okay. Okay, so ayan, ito malaking bagay po na may whiteboard tayo. So sa mga teacher po dyan na katulad ko, you may use this type of technique in para may live ano po, live whiteboard. Okay? So, ganito, magsusulat na ako dito sa gilid ng mga occupation. That is shokugyo. Shokugyo. Okay? Shokugyo. Kapag job, sutume. Sutume or shigoto. Shigoto. That is Japanese word. Okay, ano magbigay tayo ng mga ano? Example, student. Ano ulit? Eh, wag to. Ba naman? Baker. Tanya. Okay, dentist. Aisha. Okay, tayo kahit mga sampu. Okay, number three, receptionist. Uketsuke gakari. Uketsuke gakari. May mga ituturo ko iba pang tips. Okay, next. Next one, it is ano ba mga ano? Wait, wait. Chota mate, chota mate. Company president. Chacho. 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 Okay. Lawyer. Tengoshi. Policeman. Businessman na lang. Ah, sige, policeman. Teka. Pilot. Okay. Pilot, piroto. Okay. Hindi natin lagyan ng space. And para mahaba. Okay, yung dami yan na natin. Gawin natin sampu. Kahit mga sampu. Okay, kaya kailangan memorize nyo po yung mga occupation. Mga marami, maraming occupation. Okay, marami po talagang occupations. So, kailangan memorize mo po yan. Okay? So, another one, Chef Ryori Ningashira. Kasi pagkain po yung Ryori. Ryori Ningashira. Ningashira or Chef po. Okay, and 9. Businessman. Ah, sorry. Inuna ko yung ano. Inuna ko yung B. Ayan. That is Japanese word. Businessman. And nurse. Kangofu. Alright. So these are the basic occupation in Japanese. Oh, basahin na muna natin. Occupation. Shokugyo. Job. Sutume. Shigoto. Baker. Panya. So as you can see, pan, that is bread. In Japanese, pan. So yung nagtitinda, pan niya, baker. Yung baker, pan niya. Okay, dentist, Aisha. Receptionist, Uketsuke Gakari. Company president, Shacho. Lawyer, Bengoshi. Policeman, Keikan. Pairoto. Chef, Ryorinin Gashira. Shefu. Businessman. Nurse, Kangofu. So, yun na. Dapat repeat after me. Panya. Aisha. Uketsuke Gakari. Shacho. Bengoshi. Keikan. Pairoto. Ryorinin Gashira. Shefu. Businessman. Kangofu. Alright. Okay, sample, ribbon. Okay, number one. Balik tayo sa, no? Okay, she is a dentist. Okay, so if you know the answer, just write in the comment section. Okay, give you 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So the answer is Kanojo wa. So she, I guess, what is Kanojo? Followed by particle wa. What is dentist? So check here. Aisha. And then this is, since this is as a present tense, affirmative, des. Okay? Des po ang nilalagay. So that's the answer. Kanojo wa Aisha des. Okay? Next one. How about this one? Are you a pilot? Okay, so again, 5. Okay, sorry. Go, yon, san, ni, ich. That's the answer. Kote, kadasai. That is. Anatawa, you. Anatawa, Eroto. Deska? Anatawa, Eroto, deska? Next one. He is not a baker. He's not a baker. Go, yon, san, ni, ich. Otaete kadasai. That's the answer. Okay, so I is karewa. Karewa. Anya. Dewa arimasen. Dewa arimasen. Karewa panya dewa arimasen. Okay, next one. I was a lawyer. Okay, do you know the answer? Go, yon, san, ni, ich. Kotaete kadasai. Okay, that is watashi wa bengoshi. Deshta. That's the answer. Okay, that's the answer. Ayan, para kasya. Okay. Next one. Next one. Number five. Was she a chef? Okay, so that is interrogative. Okay, answer. Go. Yon san ni ich. That is kanojowa chefu. So shortcut na tayo agad, chefu. Deshta ka. Okay, the answer. Okay, next one. Bigitin na natin. Marami tayong space. Diba? Next one, number six. You were not a company president. What's the answer? Right answer is Goyon San Ni Ich. Okay, that is Anatawa Tacho Ewa Arimasen. Okay, next one. They are teachers. Ayan, but as you remember, they are teachers. Oh, sige nga, try to answer this. 5 seconds. Go yon sang ni each. Karera wa, so that is plural. Karera wa, what is teacher? Sensei Tachi. Kasi nga, plural. If you remember, one of the rules, if you remember, in Meishin Nihongo, yung Tachi, add Tachi to the noun, di plural. But it is not, di naman ganun ka-record. Kung nilagay nyo karerawa, sensei des, okay, it's correct. But mas maganda kung karerawa, sensei Tachi des. Next. He is also a tourism students. She is also a tourism student. Oh, ngayon may pagbabago na. Nayroon ng word na also. Oh, sige, let's try to answer this. Okay. Let's try to answer this. Okay, so five. Go yon san ni ich. So, So, napansin nyo, kanojowa nilagay ko, pero may also, diba? So, kanojumo, kanku, no, gakusei, kankuno, gakusei, yes. Okay, so, ibig sabihin, yung also or to, kapag nakita niya po yan, ang lalagay niya, instead of using wa, use particle or suffix mo in the sentence after pronoun. Kapag ganito po, kapag also or to na. Okay, mo. So, kanojo mo, kanko no, gako say, this. Next, example. He is Also, he was also a policeman. Nako. So, karera wa, I mean, kare mo, ikan, testa. Okay? And lastly, as for PBT, so, are they students or are they Japanese students? So what's the answer? That is Anata Tachi. Kasi marami. Anata Tachi wa Nihongo no Nihongo no Gakusei Peska. So that is the right answer. Okay, so let's proceed. Let's recap. She is a dentist. Kanojo wa aisha desu. Are you a pilot? Anata wa pairoto desu ka? Anata wa pairoto desu ka? He is not a baker. Kare wa panya de wa arimasen. I was a lawyer. Watashi wa bengoshi deshita. Was she a chef? Kanojo wa shepu deshita ka? Kanojo wa shepu deshita ka? You were not a company president. Anata wa shacho de wa arimasen deshita. They are teachers. Karera wa sensei tachi desu. She is also a tourism student. Kanojo mo kankuno gakusei desu. He was also a policeman. Kare mo keikan deshita. Are they Japanese students? Anata tachi wa nihongo no gakusei desu ka? So that is it, no? So it is all about be verb desu using in Japanese sentence with occupation. So that, so technique number one tip: memorize the pronoun and possessive pronouns in Japanese. Do not forget wa and mo, the also or to na mo, and then followed by the occupation. So do not forget all the occupations or titles. Okay, like this, and then the conjugation of desu, deshita, dewarimasen, dewarimasen, deshita, deska, deshita ka. So it is very easy to understand. Okay, so I hope you learned a lot. Minasang ohayo, minasang domo arigato gozaimasu. I hope you learned a lot. And do not forget to share, like, and subscribe my channel. Again, J40s Pulumbari. Bye-bye. Minasang kyotsukete. Dewa mata. Ano yung record ko dito? Oh, wala.